So, you know, some of these stores could be selling for as low as maybe, you know, 1,000 pesos a day, to upwards of maybe doing a couple of 100,000 a day. So the spectrum is really quite large. But, you know, when you walk around the streets of our country, you can't really say which one is big, which one is small. But and that sort of segmentation is very hard to decipher for most companies. So they would typically go through traditional wholesalers and distributors to do that job. But really, you have to be present in sort of industries to be able to know how to really design a logistics model, a service model that will cater to each and every one of them. As we say in grocery, it doesn't really matter how small you are, no store is left behind.
All right. One of the challenges, perhaps, of a lot of these small businesses is capitalization. A lot of them do not have access to standard financial services. A lot of them go to loan sharks, in fact, to borrow money for capital. And now you're opening opportunities for a lot of these businesses to get capital from established sources. So, how has the response been to this feature?
That's right. Now, we recently just launched a business called SariPay, which is under the grocery umbrella, which is trying to do exactly that. I think the interesting thing is as you start to solve the supply chain challenges of inventory replenishment, you get to learn about their transactions and you get sort of alternative KYC information that allows us to credit score the Sari-Sari stores in a way that has never been done before. And because of that, we're able to give them access to working capital loans at a much better interest rate because we have a much deeper understanding of their sort of business cash flow movement. So we're in effect taking them away from the traditional loan sharks. And one of the biggest thing we've learned really is that because these stores are so hungry for, you know, some sort of formal fintech solution to come to them, we've found that their sort of default rate is almost none, close to none. And all of these small stores, contrary to our belief, that we think, you know, they don't have the ability to pay or they don't have the willingness to pay. Actually, we've seen the reverse, that the humblest of stores are the ones that are the most diligent in terms of paying back their loans.
Okay, ER, you mentioned about tech. How much digitalization can actually a small business like a lot of our Sari-Sari stores, how much digital can they embrace, if you will?
I mean, you'll be surprised, Stanley. I think the pandemic and sort of the onslaught of digital revolution has helped. But the way we would do it is we try to design our apps in such a way that if you're comfortable with using basic platforms like YouTube or Facebook, you should be able to use one of our apps in grocery. That sort of is the benchmark. But we do see that trend continuing to improve. I must say that not all stores are still comfortable in using digitization, but that just keeps on growing year on year. So we're optimistic about the trend in terms of continuously adopting digital in this segment.
All right. A lot of the challenges also that a lot of Sari-Sari stores and small businesses are facing are, of course, competition. We know for a fact that nationwide chains of convenience stores are also penetrating small neighborhoods that were formerly serviced by these stores. How is that panning out, and how are you helping them survive competition?
Actually, what we realize is that for these small stores, resiliency is not the issue. Because a lot of these small stores don't really pay rent, or they also don't employ any employees, so to speak. So their operating expenses are close to none. So the requirement to sort of shut down during volatile times is not really there. As opposed to sort of more formal formats where, you know, you pay rent, you have, there's aircon, there's employees, that is a lot more sort of susceptible to
Overhead
these
expenses
changes. No,
actually are lower.
exactly. Correct. So the opportunity for Sari-Sari store is really growth rather than resilience. So what we think we're able to do is by organizing all of these suppliers under our tech platform, we are giving them access to the world and we're giving the world access to them. And in doing so, we are giving them a fair chance of growing as well.
Okay, you've been in this endeavor for 7 years now. How much growth have you seen as far as pushing or supporting Sari-Sari stores are concerned all around the country? And where are you exactly?
So this year is our 7th year. We started grocery in 2016 back in Rizal, where we were able to sort of grow to about 1,000 stores at the time. Now, 7 years after, we have over 250,000, close to 300,000 stores in the platform. And we are present nationwide. So last year we opened a few provinces in Visayas, Bacolod, Cebu, Iloilo, a few provinces in Mindanao, Gensan, Davao, CDO. And we hope to continue the expansion in the coming years.
Okay, all of those years of experience must have given you an insight on the small businesses in the country. What do you think should the government roll out to help MSMEs and even sari-sari stores, smaller businesses, even thrive?
I think the government has been rather supportive of digitization, which is something that comes, very favorable to us. I do think that we could do more with the government because platforms like Grocery and the other startups out there are really creating sort of platforms and data centers that can work with government so that programs can follow. So we look forward to sort of more partnerships, not just with the government, but also with the private sector. But so far, we have seen more support than constraints across the board. So we're very happy with that.
Lastly, how does that work? Do they go to you, I mean, the small business, or do you seek them out? And how do they get in touch?
So they can simply download Grocery via the Google Play Store. And as they do that, they will be guided in terms of how they would register. They have to be a sari-sari store, and we have ways to verify that. And once that's done, that's it. We take care of the rest.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for joining us and giving us insight. E.R. Olian, CEO of Grocery. Thank you a lot. Or thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Stanley.
Have a good day.